Hi, I'm Alex with WebLabPro.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to start a blog. We're going to get hands-on, and you can watch me start one right now. Before I start, I want to let you know that while you can start a blog by setting up an account with a blogging platform like Blogger.com for free, and that's fine if you want to go that route. It's as easy as registering, and that will get you a blog, but there's lots of limitations going that way. You won't have your own .com name, you'll have limited themes, plugins, and functionality. And the worst thing is you'll be heavily limited on being able to make money off your blog. I'm sure you've heard of lots of people making money online blogging by writing what they're passionate about. Well, this is the kind of blog you'll need if you want to do that. And if you don't care about making that passive income off your blog, well, this is still the way to do it. Here's an overview and a quick checklist of what's needed. First is have an idea of what your blog is going to be about. And this goes without saying, and I'm sure that if you're here watching this video, you already have a general idea of what your blog is going to be about. Second is a domain name. This is your .com name, your web address. Third, we'll set up a web hosting account. And fourth, we'll install WordPress as our website. This will be our blogging application. So step one is done. I'll assume you already know what you want to blog about. Step two and three can be done at the same time because most hosting companies offer the ability for you to get a domain name through them. Some will offer it for free. Some will charge for that domain. The hosting company I host my websites and blogs with is HostGator at the current time. I've been doing this for a very long time, and I've used all the major web hosts, and as of now, I prefer HostGator. But feel free to make your own decision, and know that generally the shopping cart process and setting up the web hosting is pretty much the same with all the major web hosts. And that is, you'll pick a plan, select your domain name, and input your billing info, and then you'll have instant access to the server's control panel, where you can start your website and have it available to the world in minutes. Okay, so now we're at HostGator.com, the web hosting company which will host our website, the blog. A hosting company basically rents you memory space on their industrial-grade computers called web servers, and you upload your website there. That way your site can handle lots of visitors 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. That's how websites work. So we'll select web hosting, and currently they have 3 plans available. Here's the main difference. The basic level plan only allows you to have one domain hosted with one account, while the mid-level plan allows you to have unlimited domains, meaning that if you want to start a different blog with a whole different topic, you'll be able to set up more than one blog or website under one hosting account with a whole different web address and so on. And the business level plan offers private SSL and IP address. The main reason you would want this is if you're planning on selling products directly through your blog, kind of like an e-commerce site, where your visitor inputs credit card information right on your website. The credit card companies require this, it's a security thing. So we'll select a plan, and on the order page, the first thing we'll do is enter a domain name. And we'll have to choose if we want our web address to be .com, .net, .org, whatever you want it to be. Obviously, it has to be available, and they'll tell us that here. So we'll enter it here, and after that, it's a pretty basic online shopping process. We'll have to select a billing cycle, a username, a PIN. You'll enter your billing information, and they will try to sell you more things. I generally don't get any of them because I don't need them, but feel free to make your own decision. Really, the only one that is to take into consideration is domain privacy. You see, when you register a domain, the owner's information is made public. So if you want to have your information private, get the domain privacy. Then simply continue and create the account. They will charge your credit card, and they will send you an email with access information to the server. Now we're logged in, and we're presented with lots of icons that can control lots of things on our hosting account. It's configured, so there isn't anything you really need to do, unless you know what you're doing. Really, the few things you'll want to visit is email accounts. This is where you can create email accounts at your own domain. Logs, so you can check traffic stats for your site. But for right now, we're going to visit the software section. And this is where we'll install the WordPress blog to our server. Sometimes web hosts configure the control panel differently, but generally you'll see one of these. Fantastical, simple scripts, or quick installs. These are software libraries which enable you to install very easily some of the most popular open source web applications available for free. This is the fourth thing we need, which is WordPress. And WordPress is by far one of the most popular web applications of all time. It's blogging software and a content management system. Some of the most popular websites on the internet run on WordPress. On top of being the best blogging application, with WordPress you can build an e-commerce site, a membership site, or manage a very wide variety of websites. Okay, let's install it. Click on it and select New Install. And if you have multiple domains, select the one you want to install it to. You'll have a choice if you want to install it to the root of the site or into a subdirectory. We'll install it to the root, so we'll leave this field empty. You would install it to a subdirectory if you already had a working website and would like to add WordPress to that site. And if you install it to a subdirectory, then your site will not be accessed if visitors type in just a domain name. They would have to enter the subdirectory as well, and that doesn't make sense. So we're going to make this the main site by installing it to the root. Then there's a few other fields, username and password that you want for the control panel of WordPress, a site name, description, etc. You can change these later on from the WordPress control panel. Install it, and a few moments later, you'll have a website up and running and waiting for you to customize it and fill it with content. If we visit our site, now it's working, and we'll have a default empty site up. To access the control panel, we'll go to whatever the domain name is, .com/wp-admin/, enter your login info, and then you arrive at the control panel. And from here, the fun begins. You can add blog posts, pages, change the appearance by downloading new themes, control how the menu appears, download plugins, enhance functionality. There's lots to WordPress, and this video is not about that, but there's tons of information on the web about it. I've also created a page at weblabpro.com dedicated to this video. You'll find a link in the description. There's more free videos there. They're all in one place, which I know will really help you get started with WordPress. Check them out. If my video helped you, please hit the like button, share, comment, subscribe, because I have more videos coming. And that's it. Thanks for watching.